Trusting his army had destroyed Theoden's people at Helm's Deep, Saruman believed himself secure in his tower of Orthanc. But the ringed walls of Isengard proved no defense against the vengeance of Ents and men. And within Saruman's pits, many wrathful Rohan prisoners awaited liberation, while his machineries belch foul vapors. Above, Saruman directs his defense and marshals his sorcery, for the battle is far from certain. And now Ent and Rohirrim alike must face Saruman's wrath.
They once tortured our friends below! The entrance to their pits must be thrown open! They're running out of men!
Thank you.
Anton carries the key to the Tower of Orthanc. We must capture it for Treebeard. Your forked tongue.
You shall please Lord Saruman to join his prisoners here.
The traitor Wormtongue is no more. You have the key. Hurry it to Treebeard.
Out to take you.
You waste your strength, fool.
Saruman hides inside. side, atop the stairs!
So weak. So very weak. I have servants without number.
His power shattered, Saruman could not prevail against the courage that was arrayed against him, and in the end, his betrayal was avenged. Treebeard now serves as master of Ortha, and the pits of Isengard have been cleansed of Saruman's filth. But the Dark Lord's power has not been broken, for Saruman served merely as a pawn, a distraction to weaken Gondor's borders. Within Mordor, the armies of Sauron grow, and his war has hardly begun.